So now that we have talked about some of the fundamentals of design, like color theory and typography, the next thing I want to talk about is user interface design, which is commonly known as UI. Now, take a look at this picture. In most cases, 90% of you would have read "Look here first, Christmas, then Ray." So this is just a way that our brain works. We are always drawn to the bigger, bolder, square of things. As a designers, we can use this knowledge to define hierarchy. So let's say that you were to write a birthday invite to Jane. You could write it like this, but all of the information has equal weight. So as a reader, I have to go through the entire paragraph and I can't just skim through it to get the important bit. So it's gonna take me a lot longer. Now on the other hand, if I apply the rules of hierarchy, then the most important information gets conveyed over first and I make sure that Jane actually knows whose birthday party it is, where they should go. So we can establish hierarchy in a number of ways. The most obvious is through the use of color. So colors that really pop and stand out and have contrast with that background tend to be used for hierarchy. So for example, in this example, if all the colors were the same, then it feels like they all have equal importance. But on the other hand, if we have something that's very bright, standoutish, versus something that's a bit more grayed, a bit more muted, then we know exactly where our eyes will go to first. Now, if you take a look at this example, this is the ASUX website, and their predominant color palette is the sort of gray and white color, but they have really cleverly use their accent tone, this green and red, to really tell the user that they think you should really look at. And it seems like ASUX really cares that you know that they have an outlet and also that you add your product to the bag so that they can actually make money off you. So in this case, they are using that green accent tone to really pull the eyes to that button and to make sure that the user actually completes their transactions. Now, in addition to color, you should also think about size, because as I said, the bigger items draw your eyes to it. For example, if you look at the Coinbase website, which you can use to buy cryptocurrency, we can see the first thing they want to tell you is you can use this website to buy and sell cryptocurrency. Now, the next biggest thing on the page is this huge email input and a button that says "Get Started." So because a lot of these companies run ads and they are paying for users to land on their page, it's really important for them to capture the emails. This is a kind of what this design is representing, right? As long as you land on this page, you are probably going to want to look at this place where you put in your email address and get started so that the company can capture your information. Now, in addition to establishing hierarchy, in terms of user interface, you should think about the layout of your website. You can, of course, on the other hand, have this big block of text, which is just your website where everything is all laid out in the same kind of way. Or you can create more interest by creating a block of text and then interpressed with pictures and then create some different sizes and different shapes and different hierarchies to make your design look more interesting. Now, the Wikipedia page are example in bad design, because just look at how blurred it really is, trying to be an encyclopedia, but it doesn't have to be like this. Now, one of the most noticeable thing about Wikipedia is just the length of each block of text. Just look at how long each line of text is. It's very hard for a user to just keep tracking along the same line. And in fact, in terms of user interface design, there is an optimal line length too long and it gets a little bit tedious to read, but too short, it really feels bit too choppy and it's a bit awkward to read. So you want to claim and aim for something around 40 to 60 characters per line so that it feels comfortable to the users and they will be able to get through the information and still be interested in your website. Now, when you have a good layout like Grammarly website, it's not only interesting, but it also chops up the content into smaller pieces so that you actually get through more of the website and you take more of it in. Now, another thing I want to talk about is alignment. This has to do with how you position each of the elements on the screen relative to each other. So take a look at the example on the left. The top title is centered aligned, whereas the body text is left aligned, and it makes it look a bit awkward, like they are not really meant to be together. Now on the right, however, just by shifting the alignment so that both starting points are the same for the title and the body, it suddenly looks a lot more consistent and a lot more designed. One of the easiest way of making any sort of design you create look professional, as I say it look professional, is just to reduce the number of alignment points. So let's say that you are creating a slide deck for your next presentation, or you are creating a poster for your birthday party. Take a look at all the designs that are on the design and identify a line that goes through the beginning of each item. Now, if you can reduce the number of lines like we have done here on the right, then suddenly the design looks a lot more coherent, like all the pieces are meant to be together, and it just looks a lot more professional. So use these grid lines in your design to help you visualize where the starting point of each element is and trying to line them all up, because even if you do nothing else but just alignment, you can see in this case the left looks a lot more sloppy and the right looks a lot more designed and more professional. And all that changed, there is no change in the color, there's no change in typography, it's just the alignment. Now, a really important concept is in all design is white space, and white space refers to the empty space that around text or around your element. Now, here's an experiment. Take a look at this shop that sells handbag and take a look at this one. Now, how much are you willing to pay for a handbag from this shop versus this one? Now, this is really a use case for white space. A lot of luxury shops, luxury designer stores, one of their simplest tools is just injecting white space around their product. Space thins out and it makes everything suddenly look a lot more expensive, whereas when you have everything all tightly crammed together and you have a lot of products on show, it makes it look like it's sort of discount store. And the same principle applies when it comes to digital design as well. Let's say you have an ad for noise cancelling headphones. If you have leads or loads of things on screen, there is new only $20, 100% noise cancellation. It makes the product look really cheap, whereas if you inject some white space, all of a sudden it looks like Apple made it, right? Just by adding that space around each element on the screen, you can make your design a lot more minimalist and all the same time elevated. Now, the last thing on user interface design I want to talk about, and probably the most important, is design for your audience. A lot of things I've said, including not using Comic Sans, it really depends on your audience. Let's say you are designing a children's concert poster. the one on the right look like something that children might actually want to go to. The one on the left looks a bit like a funeral advertisement. It's so serious. It's so black and white, and it's so several looking that no child is kind of want to go to that concert. So think about your audience. Think about what would appeal to them and what's important to convey to them. That it's going to be a fun concert, or that is going to be a boring adult who are going to be reading newspapers and some sort of classical band in the background. Then you are designing website design. It's for your audience, even if it's something a little bit messier, a little bit bolder in terms of color, as long as it fits your audience, and that's perfectly fine. So have the flexibility in your design so that you are not just creating one style all the time. You are creating one style for a particular audience, like teenagers who want to buy clothes, and you are creating a different style for people who want to buy and sell cryptocurrency or have a medical website. So the flexibility in your design skills is really important when it comes to the user interface design. But keep in mind these five things: hierarchy, layout, alignment, white space, and your audience, and you will be well and way to creating some and more beautiful user interfaces for your web design.